Hello, everybody on my wonderful YouTube. I'm so sorry. There's been like a lot of internet issues here, and I just haven't been able to do a lot. So, when this gets posted, it is. And that was my Wi-Fi going out again because my Wi-Fi doesn't know how to stay on. But, anyways, we shall continue finally with this grueling long game. All right, I had to make sure everything was okay. I had to make sure infinite mode was still off because we would not want to go through this game and be struggling. And while we are doing all of this, I'm gonna go send Rebecca back.
I'll go check over there.
Okay.
So we can actually pick up a lot of this stuff. But from my knowledge, we have a lot of stuff already. Yeah. That's what I thought. Oh, I could have picked up the hand cannon, actually. Oh. I know this isn't a live stream or anything, so there's probably gonna be a lot less talking. You'll probably hear me making comments to myself or anything. I don't know how many of you actually do know me or actually do follow this. I know I have like 4 subscribers, but I love you 4 subscribers, so and I know I really don't, even when I do get on, I don't talk much when I do have a live stream on. It's probably because of the lack of confidence I have. Probably should fix that though. And you guys probably don't even want to hear me talk about it, which is cool. I don't even remember what I'm supposed to be doing here, actually. So you might see me run around in circles like this for a little bit. Oh, you know what? Actually, I could take this gasoline can. Yeah. We can take this because I'm gonna need it. So basically, we're back up here for that. Okay. So what else are we gonna do is we're gonna do this puzzle that everyone has to search, even though it's very, very easy. Rekindle it from the week and you do the food chain. Hello? I'm trying to do this off of memory. This is gonna be super ugly if I get this wrong now. But no, didn't want that. I should probably reload that shotgun though. Yeah, see, I did it ugly. The ones that I always get wrong are the horse and the cougar. Because I always feel like a cougar should be able to kill the wolf. But I guess, because cougar can outrun a wolf, I guess. I don't know. I mean, not a cougar. A horse can outrun a wolf, but it can't escape a cougar, so it's whatever, in my opinion. That's the puzzle, second time through. I'm so used to playing Leech Hunter mode that I'm always ready for a hunter to jump on top of me and a first aid or a green herb to be right there waiting. You might hear from my mic because I know my TV's so loud sometimes that you just hear it from my mic. You might hear trophies pop up that I haven't got yet, so maybe, who knows?
This way. I'll go.
Yeah.
This way.
It's also really weird to play right now because I haven't played this in a while and I'm trying to just do this just to get this play over with because I was looking on YouTube yesterday. I was like, oh. I haven't finished this. That's GTFO. Yeah, I like I'm so sorry. I like realize I have a Resident Evil 1 playthrough up there too, like in 15 minute segments that I've yet to finish too. So please forgive me for not finishing them yet because I'm really bad. Like, not, well, in general, I'm bad at every video game I play. Just fair warning. But I'm just really bad at like starting stuff and getting distracted and then, coming back to supposed to finish it and then I don't do it. Yeah, I'm that guy. I don't know if I was showing you guys all the cutscenes or not, or if I was just going through the game, and
Let's split up.
Roger.
See, I thought I was cute till this happened.
Come on.
Okay.
Battle sequence complete. Unlocking there. Mirror. Look at me, I'm a fucking machine. Now the real question is to waste this full heal on Rebecca to carry the 17 rounds of machine gun bullets, or
I'll go.
Yeah, we're gonna use this full heal. I'm just that confident. I don't know if I was doing a no heal run. I don't remember. At the same time, I also don't care.
This way.
Roger.
I know I also started this on my friend's account, and I know I'm doing it without the machine gun playthrough, so I should probably finish that. Oh, crap. When you think you're good and you can run. I know some days I'd be struggling on this health situation. Like, I remember the first time I played this, I went all the way back. I had to kill monsters to get a first aid spray that I should have knew that I left in a room full of zombies. I was like, I probably won't need this. Oh, those were the days. And then you remember. Oh. Just chill out, Billy. My one thing, like, why are you holding... Like, if it was a hunting gun, I probably wouldn't be as upset. Okay. So, there's this machine gun ammo that I will beautifully snatch up. Along with these Molotovs. I hope these are not infinite. They are not. My lucky day.
Go alone.
Roger.
I forgot to pick up health, actually. That's one thing I know I forgot to do. Okay, so the thing why I did that is if you want to ever clear that room out, you either tell your partner to wait all the way down there and then say follow me and then, you know, go through the door. Most basic of basic tricks, it still works. Billy's inventory is hella empty, or you, if you have the ammunition to spare, like I do with this extra weapon, you tell your partner to wait, go up there and wait at that spot, and they will kill everything because that area is glitched out to where nothing can hit you. I was about to say, there should be something in here. But I know I am gonna need Rebecca here. I used 5 shots, right? One more. This is ugly. I should have grabbed a grenade launcher. One. Caution, because I'm stupid. Danger, because I'm really stupid. No, not yet. I should be danger. I should. I hope I'm not. See, I was even used to zombies being in here. And I'm actually 100% glad they aren't. I thought that was a reload button. Yeah. Right there. Okay, that's beautiful. That gives Rebecca a very strong weapon. We have one tablet out of three. Imagine it shows like stone. It says 1/3. Yeah. Imagine that. Be cool if I wasn't on PlayStation. Be lame like that. I don't remember if I grabbed the first aid. I mean, the health out of this area. I don't remember. I'm gonna go check real quick. Anything to stop me from using that first aid spray or that poison herb? I'm not poison, blue herb mix will be great. I probably did grab the health though because I'm a greedy bitch. Yeah, I'm a greedy bitch. I should be 100% aware of how greedy I am. Okay, so while we're here, we have two choices. Resident Evil 3 time. Duh, duh, duh. Go regroup with Billy, or we can go get some health real quick. Chances are Billy won't die since I will be with him. And this health probably would be better used to fight this bat upcoming. So, we're still gonna go grab it. But before we grab it, we are gonna go check our map to make sure we don't have anything else. We have that one green herb that I said we're gonna save. We have this, and then we have a first aid spray. Now, I don't think there's any more poison enemies beyond here. I could be wrong. And I probably am dreadfully wrong. I'm pretty sure there's more spiders beyond this point. But the chances of you actually getting poisoned are pretty low. Unless you're that very unlucky person that gets poisoned. Yay, secret passage opened up. Yay. I don't remember if I do have the hookshot though in here. Do I? I don't, so guess I do. Shit, I'm upset. I should have waited. Oh, okay, so this is the part where we're gonna exchange the shit out of everything with you, Billy, because you only have that one gun. Then we're gonna change to you, equip that, and we're gonna give me this. You can hold on to that too. We have a lot of stuff. Just remember to always keep your inventory at least with two or three spaces open. In a normal playthrough, you more than likely will not have the submachine gun. If it's your first time on hard, it's probably best that you have both your pistols. I mean, I know a lot of people say, why don't you get rid of Rebecca's pistol at the start? It's because it's an extra gun, and in hard, that last extra gun matters. I mean, once you get the revolver and the grenade launcher, just save up those rounds. The shotgun doesn't really matter. The hunting gun, you can keep the hunting gun, I guess, but that's just more, that's like having two handguns. Like, you'd rather have someone using handgun bullets than the other one using a shotgun for strong enemies, you know? You know, basic survival tips.
Let's regroup.
Roger.
And now that both their inventories are full, this is gonna be hard to manage. I won't say hard, I'm just gonna say it's irritating to manage. Alright, now, to my knowledge. I don't remember what something comes out here. So, we're going to do the old.
You stay here.
Yeah.
And I am gonna go clear room because that gives me time to waste machine gun bullets. So, if you will excuse me. Dum 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 dum. Bam, and look, we have inventory open to go grab those shotgun shells. Just for you, Billy. I had to make sure. I know through all the difficulties, they do change some ammo placements or ammo sizes. Like, I know from an easy, there's a lot of bullets in a handgun. I think 45? And then it's like some places are 30, some places are 15. All right, Billy. I'm gonna have you eat up. And we're also going to give you the shotgun shells because you deserve them. Hunters in here? I think so. Nothing? Oh. This is the part where you run past him and go into the room with Rebecca. I actually was not expecting that. I thought he triggered in the other room, and I thought I was like, oh, I'm safe. Yeah, I was wrong. There's a red herb and empty bottles in here. Thank God I brought you in here, Billy. Oh, you don't have an empty bottle. Do you have space? Well, this is interesting. Cause guess what, my niggas? We about to run out of room too. But you know, that is fine because you know what we have? We have a lot of stuff. So, what I am going to do is, I'm going to take the key items and run with Rebecca. Yes. We still have to come back for Billy though, so I guess it doesn't really matter. So, to make sure I come back, I'll just take that. Because then I have to take Billy. Yeah, he's on way, right? Okay. Plus, there's that red herb, so that gives me a chance to actually go down there and grab the green herb now. Plus, it's easy for one person to slip past. Spencer. And now we have this tablet, so you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna leave you right here. We're gonna drop the shit out of you. Bam, drops. Gotta drop it like it's hot, cause it's a key item. I know I'm 100% lame. Bear with me. And 100% gay, so hey. Can't win them all. Bam, we got that too. Look at this. This is beautiful. Okay, so now you got 9. You got 9 Magnum bullets. Look at that. You're already off to a great start, but we still don't have a Magnum. Fifteen Molotovs. Look at you. You are looking mighty fly. But you still have a long way to go from being the best. It's good that I came down here though to grab this green herb, because that means now I have an extra healing item. A healing item that can in turn save your life. And probably will on hard. And actually, conserving healing items for new people are harder. Like, I've watched my brother play this, and let me tell you, the struggle could not be any more real on hard for him. He even had the machine gun. This machine gun, though, I promise you, getting the machine gun will improve your chances, like, 100%. Like, there's not a reason you can die. Unless there's an instant kill. Whoa! I did not expect those. You shouldn't really go into rooms that you don't need to. I'm pretty sure there's some out here too, so. Sit down, shut up. Girl, we heard your whole story. The one thing I am glad about the remasters, though, is that they didn't change to where enemies dropped items, because that would take the whole point away. I know at one point that was talked about, though, which I guess would be okay for some enemies, but not all of them. Like, I know it doesn't spawn with all of them, but, like, just for this game alone, like, if you think about 0 and 1, 2, 3, and Code Veronica, if the enemies dropped items, think about how easy it would be for you to, like, actually go back and be like, oh, yeah, I got this. Although I know this one isn't as convenient as 1, 2, or 3, or Code Veronica, because the storage case, the big trunk, and save rooms are not a big factor in here. Like, there are typewriters in here, yeah, don't get me wrong, but it's not like the biggest factor, and it doesn't hit them. It really, to leave your weapons behind, it's kind of more, it's a lot more realistic, and I like this a lot more than one's real survival mode, where, you know, you leave your weapons in a storage case, and then you remember each storage case is not linked. That one's terrible. It was fun, but it's terrible. Hey, Billy, long time no see. I have a first aid spray over there, too. Well, shit. I wouldn't have been greedy then. Yeah, no, that's not chill at all. I'll hold both of the healing items. Okay.
Come on!
Okay.
Okay, after my next big boss kill, I'll save. And we will call this part 3. And then part 4 will be your last one. I don't want to be like the Harry Potter series, where I have like 2 million movies and you were like, come on, finish it already. I've read the entire book. This should have been done in movie 3. Which is how I felt about Lord of the Rings. They put that whole fucking book in. That shit was retarded. Really long. Oh yeah, this is also like the big part of the game where you want to move everything now and not leave it in that main room. Even though I killed those monkey, those chimpanzees, whatever, I killed them right there. It doesn't mean it's chill to leave everything right there. You always want to keep yourself like moving. Like, I'm gonna move it here, but in part 4, you're gonna see me move them again. You're gonna see me move them twice, possibly. Well, yeah, you're gonna see me at least move them 2 more times after this video. Which was like the whole reason I told Billy to wait there. Do I have to push that down? I don't think so.
Come on.
Okay.
Because I'm gonna have Rebecca pack mule everything. Yeah, we're just taking everything. We don't have really a big reason to leave anything down here alone.
Let's split up.
Okay.
I think Rebecca Campos just lags. Do not quote me on this. We're actually about to do test and fail. If she can, that would be beautiful. Okay. I feel like Billy moves it a lot faster though, so. I just always felt like both my characters should be able to push this, like an outbreak. Like that shit used to be lit, like when you played online and people would come help you push something like hella simple. Like, they'd be like, oh, you want to push this car by yourself? Yeah, we know you can. But we're gonna do this with you, Mark. Like, that shit used to be lit. And when you didn't need Mark and everyone wanted to come push it with you, like, hello?
Okay.
You have three people in there? I've only ever seen gameplay of it online. I wish I got to play it. But if the rumors of what people have been saying have been true, and I know they have been making it, and it ever does get released for the remastered version, I will be litty. Hello. I will be inviting everyone to watch that and play that shit with me. Now, see, what we're going to do now is we're going to do the giant drop. And we're going to do the big split up. Oh, yeah, that's right. The big split up. Means we are going to drop. Now see, I have Rebecca and what everything I want her to carry right there. Now I'm gonna get Billy to drop all his stuff besides the tablet, and that's gonna be Billy's inventory. This third inventory stack I'm gonna have, it's gonna be just one that we can carry. It's a hit or miss. It doesn't matter if I have this. I can't leave any more in this room. So you know what that means? Everything we get this run is gonna have to stay in our hands. So before we go down the stairs, let's see how many healing items we have. We have one in there. Now remember, Billy's gonna be able to have 6 items in his inventory after this. We just have to make sure that the hookshot is in the inventory of one of our characters. It doesn't even matter who. I'm probably gonna fight the boss as Billy. Possibly. With the machine gun. Alright. So we have this.
You stay here.
Okay.
Is there an ink ribbon right here? Thought there was. Oh, it's over there. Okay, so what's up here? First aid spray, okay. I can take the ink ribbon. Let's see what our room is. Okay, so if I take the other first aid spray, I'll have officially two healing items, which is chill to the max. So we're gonna wait right here. Oh, I should have took Billy with me, actually. And left him right there. So I didn't have to run. Oh, well. So we're going to grab this first aid spray and we're going to skedaddle out of here, too. Oh. Could you hear those footsteps? Yeah, those are monsters coming from my neck. Ah! Okay, so now Rebecca's inventory is full, so she can't take anything at all. Anything. So I possibly am gonna have to drop the hookshot outside of the church. Alright.
This way.
Roger.
We're gonna let you. Did I kill the zombies in here? This is awkward.
I'll check it out.
Roger.
I only need two items from. Two items. I need this and this. Oh, wait, hold up. I should have looked where this hand cannon is. It's to the side. And okay, so they're relatively close. So even if there's zombies in here, I should be able to dodge and weave them. No zombies? I always thought it would be cool if you can, like, you know, get into the train and, like, see what happened and, like, find new items. Like, it could have been, like, a little quickie.
Follow me.
Okay.
So now the reason why I have this big-ass Magnum with us is because eventually, well, you'll see in part four that I'm going to get set that, once again, the game separates us, and we have to fight. And you're gonna see me not struggle on that fight because that weak-ass other Magnum we're about to get is gonna mean shit to me. So now Billy should have three items. Okay. We're gonna instantly give you one of the health. We're also going to switch this inventory up and give Rebecca that so she can carry at least one thing. Since I'm not going to be able to carry much. Which, then again, if you were able to drop everything into one room, what would make it different than the storage? At least it's not where you can carry everything. Okay. So now, Billy, since you have three items, we're going to give you some of Rebecca's inventories. We're going to give you the machine gun. I said we're going to give you the machine gun. Okay, we can pick this up. And we're going to give you the machine gun. What the fuck I thought? We're going to drop this because gonna keep that actually. It says my controller's low, so that means I have like 25 minutes to finish this shit. That made me a little bit thirsty, actually. Okay. Alright, now that we got everything, like, super chilled out, this shit should be actually relatively easy. I don't know how I'm gonna do on the other account, but that's okay. Alright, let's go, guys. I thought this was a thing for killing these hoes. I guess not.
You stay here.
Damn, look at this, beautifully works. We reload fully. Okay, I don't know why he just didn't take the clip out, put it in his pocket. Probably because they assume if you're reloading, you're dropping everything. Okay, like I said before, after this boss battle, I have 2 healing items. There's no way I'm dying. Famous last words. Did I lose any health? I know I got hit. Oh, I have 1 healing item. We're gonna drop this right now. Because we won't need this hookshot in a minute. Will I not need this hookshot? I probably won't. Oh, wait. Oh, I do need it. I need it for 1 more thing. Oh, tragic. 2 more things. Oh, tragic. We'll come back for you, shotgun ammo. I have 32%. 132. I don't ever understand why they just didn't put bullets. Like, a bullet number. Like, give it 150 bullets. And, like, 150 would be it, but don't ask me, I'm not the one who makes rules. And now we're gonna do 1 more move, and then I promise you.
Come on.
Okay.
So you get to see 2 moves this game. Lovely, right? You know, it's fucking fantastic. Yay. It was beautiful. It was beautiful trip down. Look at that door. Okay, we're gonna leave everything down here, actually. I'm gonna leave... I'm gonna keep Rebecca down here, actually, since I already have the hookshot. So, we're gonna empty Rebecca's inventory out, actually. No, I should send Rebecca upstairs because that shit's easy, so I don't have to send all that stuff down to her. Fine. Smart, smart, smart. Clean as fuck, too. So, how are we doing this? If Rebecca's going upstairs, she's gonna need a heavy gun.
Split up.
Okay. Thank you.